You're watching Living Black. As the number of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander languages in use dwindles, there's one Indigenous language that's growing. Yumplatok is a relatively new language, but it has a very distinct island flavour. Stefan Armbruster reports from the Torres Strait.
It's the talk of the Torres Strait, but little known outside islander communities. One of Australia's most widely spoken Indigenous languages. It's known as Creole, Broken, Pidgin, or more recently, Yumplatok.
Yumpla means our, and talk means talk. Yep, Yumplatok, our language or our talk.
But you still can't know what they come up.
Up to about 30,000 people speak or understand it. That's among the 7,000 islanders in the Torres Strait and another 45,000 on the mainland.
It is a language, you know, an established language. It's a language that people use to communicate, same as any other language. And, you know, I wouldn't say it's a baby talk.
At Gipla Stop, where beautiful islands blooming from Mer in the east to Buigurue west.
From Thursday Island, 4MW has broadcast in language across the region since 1985.
When radio came to the scene, it brought it to that attention that we could speak Yumplatok, and people at Buigu, people at Purma, people at Merbiag and Murray Island would understand the issues that we're talking about.
Related to other Melanesian pidgins, Torres Creole began as a language of trade in the mid-1800s. Known as a contact language, it's now one of the most widely spoken of the Creoles to appear in Australia since colonisation. Missionaries from New Caledonia, using pidgin to evangelise the islands, laid the foundation.
Torres Creole emerged on Arab in the 1890s, about 20 years after the arrival of missionaries. It then slowly spread across the region, and now, seven generations later, is spoken throughout Australia.
Torres Creole mixes traditional language with variations of English words, making it the region's lingua franca.
I go read 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 1 to 12. Me, Paul, Silas and Timothy, signing this letter for you, the believer of the worship Father God.
What Creole still lacks is a definitive written form. Again, the church is playing a role, with a full translation of the Bible in Yumplatok due for release in July.
I wanted to understand the meaning in the Creole language, the Yumplatok, so that as a Melanesian or an islander, I wanted to understand what the English was saying, and I wanted to understand how would I understand in the language of Yumplatok.
Now recognised as a distinct language by the Australian Bureau of Statistics, it was counted in last year's census for the first time as Yumplatok. Last century, Torres Strait Islanders migrated for work across Australia, from building railways in Queensland to pearl shell fishing in Broome and beyond. Wherever they went, they took the Creole with them.
I tend to hear, you know, a lot of parents saying that, well, the older ones can speak, they can understand, but the younger ones don't. You know, they still, they speak English. But I find that when the children get to a certain age, then they start wanting to learn. They want to learn a language. They want to learn a traditional language. And because Creole is around them all the time, that's the language they choose to learn first.
But Creole's growing dominance means in the many remote corners of the Torres Strait, traditional languages are being lost to the young.
Well, at this stage, the Miriam Inn at Arub is dying out. It's dead. Not dying out, but dead.
Despite efforts to maintain Kala Lagoya and Miriam Mayer, there are only about 1,000 fluent speakers left.
Yumplatok is the main language we find in the schools that we use Yumplatok to as a bridge, stepping stone to introduce new ideas in the schools, and to introduce a new, not only ideas but languages in English, standard in Australian English. So Yumplatok is the stepping stone.
I taking Creole to a whole new audience, hip-hop artist Patrick Mau and his group One Blood, Hidden Image.
To separate different people from within that genre. And music, Yumplatok and traditional languages is my identity through the music, so people can identify as like, that is a Torres Strait hip-hop artist, or that is someone from Zenat Kes. You know, and people who listen to Torres Strait Islanders will understand that what I'm saying speaks about people from Zenat Kes, and they can relate to it. So Dempler can understand when I'm an island man. Some would look at it as there's a threat there that Yumplatok will overtake traditional languages, where others would say that it's a part of an evolving culture with other influences that's coming into our culture, that Yumplatok can only progress and, you know, be a form of communication that the wider community can understand.
The future looks bright for this unique Torres Strait language. Just how widespread it is across Australia will be known later this year when the 2011 census figures are released.
But even signing off, and I look forward in catching up with Yipla next week. Kapu yawo, wagar.
And it looks like we'll be hearing more Yumplatok spoken in the years to come.